All right. Welcome back, everybody. Sports Chat 503. Thank you guys very much for watching. First time, long time. Either way, I appreciate it. Coming to you live from Portland, Oregon, repping Franklin High School, Pride of Southeast out here. Yo, we are in the thick of it. We have finally got some football to talk about. We've been waiting so long for this moment. Finally here. Feels pretty good. It is Sunday. I like to kind of wait on Sunday, watch a little NFL. Get things going. Another heartbreaker for the Chargers and Herb. Oh my God, how many ways can we lose? Brutal. But at least he's not throwing the ball away at the end there. He's putting it right on the money. He's having great, great games. Over 300 yards. I mean, guys, it's just unbelievable. But we knew that. Okay, this one. Love this video. Talk about the Pac-12. Love talking about the Pac-12. It is our conference out here. Like it or leave it, whatever you want to do. Man, you got to deal with it. So we had the big game. Obviously, we were looking forward to this. USC, ASU, and you knew you were going to get a great game out of this. I thought ASU was going to win this game. I was pretty impressed early with USC. And then it happened. The idea that USC was a little overrated, ASU started coming back, ASU started making the storm, and ASU looked really good offensively, defensively. They could really run the ball against USC's. The USC's defense was not that great stopping the run. And, you know, they're just a very opportunistic team. And then all of a sudden, flipped the switch, USC started coming back, started rolling, and the ending of this game was just absolutely phenomenal. For this to be the first game on that, whatever you call it, Big Saturday or whatever, on Fox. Huge, huge opportunity for the Pac-12. So, big moment, big opportunity, and USC prevailed, which is probably what we want. If you play this out the right way, you want to have USC ranked, and you want them to stay ranked, and you want them to continue to get higher and higher ranked. Oregon, same way. You want them to continue to build and continue to get top 10, maybe USC top 15, and then you can start adding some other teams to the top 25. ASU will probably jump into the top 25 if they keep winning. But it would be really tough if you saw ASU beat USC and then drop them out of the rankings. It's all, at this point in the game, you need every single thing to break your way for the Pac-12. We already had two games canceled, which is wild. This is a year this is going to happen with the protocol, the way it's set up. A lot of guys, if they even have any sort of connection to it, trace connection or whatever, they're gone. And so it's a really amazing situation we find ourselves in. Like, for example, with the Cal situation, I heard that it was a defensive lineman was the guy who got COVID, and the rest of the whole defensive lineman group couldn't play. So they couldn't play because they didn't have a defensive line. As opposed to if it's maybe a position player and he rooms with a guy or something, and then maybe they're on different sides of the ball or whatever, which is what happened with Stanford. You had guys who maybe didn't room together or whatever, but you had guys on one side of the ball, one side of the other ball, defense and offense be affected by that. And only three players for Stanford, as opposed to Cal, where it was a lot more. So, again, this is just a weird year this year. Different things are going to happen, and you got to just work your way through it. Speaking of Stanford, I talked about this. I have the other video where I talk about just the Ducks. The Stanford game was awesome. Stanford kicker is terrible. We feel really bad for him. Coming off of last year, Jet Toner, man, missed four field goals. I mean, still wouldn't have helped Stanford in the end. I think Oregon still would have won, but it sure as hell would have helped with momentum to at least feel good about some of those drives coming down and getting some points out of it, because they did really drive the ball pretty well against Oregon's defense. I tend to think Stanford's pretty good this year. I think they're better than middle of the road. I think they're better than they were last year. If their injuries can hold out and they can stay healthy, I think that they have a real good shot. I do still think they're probably the fourth best team in the North, but Oregon did what they needed to do there. First game jitters a little bit, work that way out in the first quarter or whatever, and then move on. The Bevos, man, you know, they made it close. You know, this game was a game, was after dark. It was the only after dark game. They made it close. But you know what? I mean, they just don't have the firepower. They don't have the depth on defense. The scheme they run on offense is fairly predictable, it feels like, at times, and they just don't have the horses. And I feel bad for them at the same time. I'm kind of like, well, you know, it is what it is. Not much I can do about it. Washington State, though, I was impressed with. I did not think I'd be that impressed with Washington State going into it. I thought Oregon State was going to be able to get this win based sheerly on the idea that Washington State's had a lot of turmoil and turnover in the offseason. And I was really thinking that Oregon State was going to be a step better. They did not look better to me. They looked the same, if not even maybe even worse at times. There was sometimes shines of brightness, don't get me wrong. Same with Wazoo. But, man, it was tough. And then the game of the day, besides the USC game, I think was the UCLA-Colorado game. You know, I was very impressed with how UCLA did not give up in that game and continued to press on. At the same time, I was also thoroughly just disappointed with the idea of the defense in this game. It was a pretty wild game. This game was on at the same time the Duck game was on, and I was watching both screens. I watched the entirety of this game while the Duck game. I was watching the Duck game, and it was a really interesting game. I mean, Colorado looks again. Colorado, I thought was going to be worse than they were. Washington State, I thought was going to be worse than they were. It turns out UCLA is worse than I thought, maybe, and Oregon State's worse than I thought. I do think UCLA is still going to bring something to the table. And when Oregon plays UCLA, it should be very interesting. But I do think that Oregon's going to be the better team in that situation. And I don't see many wins on schedule for UCLA or Oregon State, for that matter. But it was a great first weekend of football. And we got to love what we see here out of these teams. I went back and watched, rewatched quite a bit of the highlights and as much as I could of the game film of some of these games that I missed. I was able to watch the whole USC game. But I didn't get to see all the Beav game, and man, I just it's going to be an up and down season, and probably more down for them. Okay, let's talk about next week. Love this, Colorado, Stanford. It's at Stanford. I don't know how the home advantage is going to work, all other than just the weather. So I think Colorado playing in Stanford. Love this. Okay, unless there's rain and everything else in Stanford Stadium, it should be fine. This could be a really good game. The way Colorado sizes it up right now, I feel like they can match Stanford's intensity and physicality. Stanford's all about if they can get their offense working. If they can get their offense working and they can start to control the clock and they can manipulate the game and feel like they're the ones in charge of the game, then they're very tough to beat. Oregon got on top of them and really started to kind of manipulate the game themselves and kind of took over that game that way. I do think Colorado is going to have an opportunity to keep this game close, but I'd like to see Stanford get their first win here. USC at Arizona, great game. Don't really know what you got with Arizona yet. Very frustrated they missed their first game. Again, any game you miss is very tough right now, but they were pretty bad. I was checking them out on Twitter. They were pretty upset about it, as was the Huskies. Pretty upset about it, missing that first game, but that's a big game right there. 12:30 start. I like both these games as a 12:30 start. Give people an opportunity to get some eyeballs on these teams because I think USC is a team that people are going to want to watch. And if they can put together a little bit of a hot streak here and beat Arizona, start off 2-0, I think this could be a real big deal for USC. I do think they're going to beat Arizona, and I think the nation should be able to watch this a little bit. It's on Fox, and it should have a lot of eyes on that. Oregon is also on Fox. We're after that USC game, prime time, 4 o'clock. Pacific time, perfect time, 7 o'clock East Coast time. This is the time slot Oregon needs to be in to get as many eyeballs on them as possible. Again, this is a year that Oregon needs to take advantage of every single opportunity it has to showcase itself in any way, shape, or form. They had a lot of good eyeballs on their game the other day, and I think this is another game that's going to be really interesting. Oregon struggled with Washington State. Oregon got beat by Washington State for 4 years straight. Broke that streak, but broke it with a very last-second field goal. These teams match up well together, scheme or not. The Mike Leach offense gives everybody problems except for the SEC at this point. But Rolovich is a real different style of play. So still throw the ball around, but not like Leach. This could be an interesting game. This could be a game where Oregon could come in a little bit sleepy a little bit. It's on the road. First opportunity to go on the road for these guys. You don't know what you're going to get necessarily It could be a weird first quarter. I mean, weirder things have definitely happened in Palouse. You know, strange things happening up there, and it's just a weird time of the year. Could be weather-wise. It could be tough. We'll keep an eye on the weather as it goes right now. You know, obviously, I've seen the weather this week. It did not look good last week. It looked like it was going to be snowing. I do think that the weather is going to play a factor. And I think it's going to be important to understand going forward how this is going to change. Because you could easily take a team like Cal, who's going to really need to have that game at the end of the year, and they have to play that thing at the end of the year. You don't know what you're going to get out of that. Right now, Pullman, you know, it's cold and it's dry, but, you know, as soon as it starts to rain or you get any sort of precip, you know, that could be snow really quickly. So they're looking in the 40s as the highs and in the low 30s. So that means anything could go for Pullman. And I do think that you're going to get something weird happening in this game. I don't see it as a blowout. I see Oregon maybe up, maybe two touchdowns at some point, and then them cutting back, or maybe it's a field goal, maybe 14, 17 points or whatever. But I would love to see Oregon just come out in the first quarter and just stomp on these guys, especially for the East Coast viewers. But I don't see it happening. I do see Oregon winning, though. Cal at ASU. Cal needs to play this game. You can't start the season with two games missing, especially if you're Cal. You are building a program right now. You're trying to get things going in the right direction. I think they are moving in the right direction, and this is a big game for them. ASU's coming off the loss, very close loss. It feels like ASU's the second-best team in the South, and not by that much. You know, SC and ASU played such a close game, and those are the two best teams it looks like in the South right now. So Cal's trying to be one of the best teams in the North, looking to try to get that. They played Washington tough the last 2 years. Really sucks they missed out on that game against Washington, because that was going to be another one of those games, just like that ASU, USC game, a real pride game for the North and for the South. But I would love to see Cal come out and do some stuff here. I like ASU because they've already played a game and they're already a little bit warmer, and it's at home for them. So I kind of like ASU in this one, and Cal could keep it close. If Cal wins, I'm not surprised, though, because I do think Cal's going to make some noise this year if they get to play it. Utah's in the same boat as Cal. Got to play this game. Got to get healthy. Got to play this game. They moved the game. It was going to be on a Friday night. Now it's going to be Saturday night. They tried to do as much as they can to try to work with these teams. UCLA, again, like I said, you know, offensively, I don't have any issues with them. You know, they look stagnant sometimes, but to me, it's all about if they can stop anybody. Their defense has been a sieve. And, you know, Utah coming into this year, you know, was a real kind of a question mark. What are they going to do with all these players? They're returning, you know, all these seniors the last year going into the Pac-12 championship, and they lose the Pac-12 championship, lose their bowl game, lose all those seniors, come back. It's a real fresh team in the eyes of a lot of guys on the Pac-12. So I would love to see what Utah has to bring. So I would like to see UCLA win this game, but I still think Utah is probably the better team at this point. And then Oregon State, Washington. Again, Washington needs to play this game, and Oregon State probably doesn't want to play Washington right now. The way Oregon State looked in the first week is not great for Washington, or not great for them going up against Washington, because I feel like Washington's going to just absolutely be flying around, really trying to get two games into one, basically. It's at Husky Stadium. It's going to be night. It's going to be wet, possibly. It's going to be, you know, it's going to be cold, and it's going to be rocking for them. So I like Washington pretty big in this one, maybe two touchdowns or more. But you never know. Weird things have happened. Oregon State played them pretty close last year, late in the season. So we'll see how that goes. But other than that, you know, we're just looking at trying to see if any of these teams can get through without having any COVID restrictions late in the week. Every week now, you're just hoping and praying. You know, for the Ducks, we heard about the Stanford guys in the morning. We're like, oh no, they're going to cancel the game. So it'd be really, really difficult to see these guys get these games canceled, because they've worked really hard to put themselves in this situation. They had a really tough offseason, and now they're trying to get their 6-7 games in if they can, get that 7th game in, you know, to make something out of this year. And then hopefully we'll have a bowls, you know. I mean, the bowls is another kind of a thing where scheduling them, but, you know, if they're going to come up and pull them off or not, I don't know. All right, guys. Thank you guys for watching Sport Chat 503. Adios.